We didn't do anything wrong. We didn't do anything wrong. But somehow we lost. This statement was made by Stephen Allop, Chief Executive Officer of Nokia, during his announcement of Nokia being acquired by Microsoft. Such an unfortunate incident, isn't it? I personally still remember flashing my Nokia cell phone model Nokia 1100, my prized possession once. In fact, Nokia 1100 was the most successful and the most sold unit in the history of cell phones. Nokia Corporation's growth was swift and mind-blowing, and same was its downfall. Let us case study the downfall of Nokia Corporation. Welcome to the podcast, Anthology of Corporate Failures. A short history of Nokia. Nokia's history dates back from 1865, when they specialized in paper and commercial products of that era. Right from the onset of 19th century, the company expanded and branched into several businesses like electricity, hydropower, etc. Starting from the late 1960s, with the advent of better telecommunications, Nokia branched into communication devices like mobiles and radio telephones for the defense and civilian needs. Post-1990 was the golden era of Nokia as it entered and ruled the cell phone market until the same was acquired by Microsoft in the year 2013. Now, let's study the downfall of Nokia. Reason number one, resistance to smartphone evolution. Repeating it, resistance to smartphone evolution. When mobile phone manufacturers were busy improving and working on their smartphones, Nokia remained stubborn with its old technology, conventional button phones to mention. Samsung soon launched its Android-based range of phones that were cost-effective and user-friendly. But Nokia's management was under the impression that people wouldn't accept touchscreen phones and would continue with the conventional button phones. Not taking up the Android revolution seriously did pave way for its downfall. Reason number two. Facing the competitors with an inferior technology. Repeating it, facing the competitors with an inferior technology. Imagine fighting a war with a water gun. That's what Nokia did. Nokia, waking up to the ground reality late, introduced the Symbian operating system as a contender to the Android operating system to capture the cell phone market. Unfortunately, Symbian operating system showed up an inferior performance and did not live up to the mark. Reason number three, moving slow in the race of competition. Repeating it, moving slow in the race of competition. When the technological world relies on disrupting technologies and innovations to stay on the top, Nokia was cool enough to make it slow and at its own pace and progress. Initially, the company overlooked the technical advancements to avoid risks associated with innovative smartphones. Instead of being amongst the early initiators, Nokia started its transition when almost every major brand had already started producing awesome phones. Reason number four, brand overconfidence. Repeating it, brand overconfidence. The company believed that even after the late launch of its smartphones, people would still flock to their stores and purchase Nokia manufactured phones. Nokia felt its previous glory would help alleviate any sort of trouble. Unfortunately, things didn't play in their favor. Recap of the failures. Reason number one, the resistance to smartphone evolution. Reason number two, facing the competitors with an inferior technology. Reason number three, progressing slower. Reason number four, brand overconfidence. Now, coming to the most interesting part, the learnings. What are the lessons that could be learnt as a fellow corporate? Number one, technological upgradation is a must in this ever-changing world. Number two, past glories on product confidence will not help us to stay forever. Number three, every product needs a future vision. Thanks for your patience and listening. Let us case study and another failure and learn from it in our next episode. Thank you.